Hi, in this video, I'm going to give you the three steps it takes to get your Harmon Kardon Invoke up and running as a smart speaker in your home, and that's more than just with Cortana. And that starts now.
Would you mind rephrasing?
Well, Cortana's decided to act up a little bit today.
Still not getting that.
Okay, we'll turn Cortana down for a moment so Cortana doesn't have its... try to get it on mute here, and it's... Okay, well, we'll just go on. Technology's great when it works. We all know that. Hi, this is Ron Nutter, and this is another edition of Tech Bites with Ron Nutter. This time, we're going to go over the steps to get your Harmon Kardon Invoke as a smart speaker in your home. And notice I didn't say just Bluetooth speaker, because it is much more than that because of Cortana being present. And I got to find another way because I keep setting this thing off, but I've just got it toned down to where we can't hear anything. I have been pleasantly surprised. Initially, I was looking at it just a physical interface to Microsoft's Mrs. C, as we'll call it. That should make it a lot happier. And I overlooked the fact of this Bluetooth connectivity. And I guess I really shouldn't have. The quality of the sound has been, well, to say phenomenal is not really giving the right words. But I tell you what, let's get to the next step and show you how to get the pairing done. And it's really very straightforward, because if you don't get any instructions with your Invoke, let's face it, sometimes things can happen. It's very simple to get it done. As you look at here on the back, you'll see, I'm going to get my finger on the right piece here, this little Bluetooth button. So you'll start the process there.
You're ready to pair. Go to Bluetooth settings on your phone or PC and select Ronald's Invoke 2.
And we'll do just that. So let's go, we'll pull down here, and I'm on my Samsung Galaxy 2. And we should see here in just a minute. I should have had this up in here a little bit sooner, but we'll have it here in just a second. Sometimes Bluetooth pairing takes a little bit of time to work. So, okay, I'll tell you what, we'll turn it off and back on. And let's go to details. Ah, there we go. Well, this is where we should start. This is when you start seeing everything that's Bluetooth in your area. So it's, okay, here we go. Now it just showed up. Good things come to those who wait. So we'll go down here and we'll tap on Invoke 2. And it may just show up as Invoke for you. I've had mine in and out a few times on configuration. So that's where I think it got a little confused. So we'll tap on that. And tap again. All right, come on. Third time's charm. Okay, there we go. I just didn't tap it the way it wanted to be tapped. Now it's going to go through pairing, and you'll be seeing a little symbol right now. You just see just as it changed. So now it's connected for media audio. So really, we're pretty much done at that point. Now, I know you say, well, why did I show you a video? This is something that, you know, three steps and pretty much you're done. But there's a hidden piece, not so much hidden, but it's under the covers within the Samsung Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus that really is kind of the secret sauce as it really makes it sit up and stand. So we're going to switch back to the screen. We'll go back into the main menu, and we want to go to sound and vibrations. This is not the way the menus are organized. Doesn't exactly make a lot of sense. Now, this is where you got to scroll down a little bit. Look down here where it says sound quality and effects. Now, this is the part that makes it with the secret sauce, the Dolby Atmos. This really makes it sit up and stand, or sit up and sing, however you want to say it. For those of you that are audiophiles or budding audiophiles, this is where you can really tweak it. If we go to advanced, you can, this is on the basic settings. You can do just very basic, if you want to dial it towards more towards vocal or more treble and bass. If you're not that into getting down into the granularity of things, that's one thing. But if you click on where it says advanced now, and that takes us back into what looks like a graphic equalizer. For those of you who've had a little higher end stereo systems in the past, you'll be familiar with this. Now, some only had three knobs for bass, mid-range, and treble. Some had more. I've had graphic equalizers that has as much as about 20 different adjustments from low to high end. So this is where you can really get fancy with it. And as you start doing different things, there are options here. Tube amp pro. Now, for those of you that love to play guitar, tube amps really have a quality sound to them you won't find anywhere else. But we've got Dolby Atmos turned on. That in itself will make some difference. But if you go down here and adapt a sound, now this is where somebody really did a lot of research, and I credit Samsung for it. If they didn't do this themselves, they got the right people involved. If you look in here, you can go default, or they've got three different age ranges, and these are pretty accurate as it describes on the screen. This is where you start seeing changes in hearing. And you know, I admit, as I've gotten a little bit older, I've lost some of my high end, but it can do things automatically to adjust for that. So I just tap the 30 to 60 year old. But if you want to see what's really going on under the hood, this is what it's showing you, that the adjustments are right now, that it's going to be fixing or adjusting on things. And you can, you know, change the sound preference where you want it clear or a little bit softer. And the best thing I can tell you on this, and by the way, if you get this all out of adjustment whack, you just tap up here in the upper right hand corner and reset to default. This is something I would proceed very slowly on, because it's going to be a little bit different maybe from what you're used to. But from what I found, at least for me in my age range, and I was not a person that listened to loud music when I was younger, I just wasn't in the group of people that I was in. We just didn't have where it could rattle the house and rattle the building. Sometimes, yeah, I did turn it up a little, but not prolonged to where your ears were ringing well after you turned the music off. Work with these settings. You may find that you may want to adjust this a little bit here. There are all sorts of things that we can adjust here. And you can see really the sky's the limit with what you want to do. And we can sit there. You know, I want to get myself in trouble a little bit here, but you can kind of see in a sense for what you've got, you know, the normal equalization, and that's fine there. If you listen to a lot of classical music, it presets that because it, you know, do a little bit differently. One of the best reference records, for lack of a better phrase, is probably available on CD by now. Used to be in a former life, I sold stereo systems while I was in college, and I kept a Telarc brand disc. That was well before they had CDs, of Tchaikovsky's 1812 Overture, recorded by the Cincinnati Orchestra or symphony, don't remember which one because I don't have the record right at hand, with live canon. When the right age person came in to the stereo place I was at, I could pull that record out, and I would say 75% of the time I could sell a system once they heard that, because it had the range and it had the kind of music they liked. So it all depends on what you're wanting to listen to. Now, you may find, you know, I would say start out with normal, depending on, you know, how much music you play versus how much spoken words, such as podcasts. There's any number of ways to do this, but the Harmon Kardon, let me go back to full screen here. I have been impressed by the Invoke, and they did not pay me to say this. They simply sent me a unit to work with in the process of my smart home piece, but this is a part of the smart home, because you're going to have, it's more and more likely now that your smartphone is going to be your sound system to a great degree. So you need speakers like this that will be able to leverage that, so you're not having to do everything with going buy a, you know, the big receiver or the amplifier and the pieces parts. This really can do quite a bit. And I was impressed with the quality of sound. So this is another way where you can leverage your smart home that you don't have to buy the big speakers. If you listen to a good set of speakers that are what I call three-way speakers, or your higher end two ways that don't have a mid-range element to them per se, and compare them to this, you're going to be hard pressed for the average person. Now, a true audiophile might be able to pick the difference, but really this for the price point of the Harmon Kardon, the quality, because Harmon Kardon is an old line name. It's a name I've known for many years. It's very respected within the industry. So they wouldn't put out a piece of garbage. This is worth looking at, especially and having Cortana in it is, just woke it up there, Mrs. C in it. I'll start calling it that. So it's worth a while. There is a link in the video to this, so that if you do decide you want to add one, if you hadn't got one already, that is an affiliate link. I will get a small commission out of it. Thank you so much for everybody who's been subscribing to the channel. Just had another subscriber come in about 20 minutes ago, and that tells me I'm heading in the right direction. So I really appreciate the time everybody's taking to watching this. And this is yet another component. You're going to see me reference this quite a bit when I'm talking about Mrs. C. You'll see me probably with the Invoke there, because it is, I mean, it's an option to having to bring out the smartphone all the time. And as I learn more things, like you've seen me do several videos on the Sonoff basic items. I had a conversation with them over email over the past day, and I'm looking at a way of controlling garage doors with it. It's going to take a little more work, because I think it's going to take a couple of, well, at least one extra component, but it's worth an option. So again, thank you for your time. Please subscribe to the channel. Make sure you click on the little bell to get notifications. If you would also take the step, which I would really appreciate, of signing up for my mail list. I will not be selling names, but if I find any special deals, or I'm reached out to by one of the manufacturers that I've been working with or has items appearing in my book, this will give me a way to get something out to you timely, because in a video, by the time you see it, it might not be an option anymore. So thank you for your time, and we'll talk to you again soon.